The high school basketball season is in the midseason push here in New Hanover County, and we've got a couple of teams fighting for a conference championship as we head through the league schedule. Good evening, everyone. I'm Joe Katz from PortCityDaily.com, and welcome to our newest edition of Sports Roundtable. This week, we'll catch up with the coaches from the girls' side of things as we head through a busy week in the Mideastern Conference. Hoggard, New Hanover, preseason favorites to win the division. Everything is playing out accordingly with Hoggard and New Hanover unbeaten inside the conference heading through this week's action. That will bring us to our first guest tonight. Leading things off is the assistant coach of the Hoggard Lady Vikings and Eric Holley. And coach, back-to-back Mideastern Conference championships, looking for another good run this season, off to a great start. Before we get to how the season's kind of playing out, I would just say moving into this year, a couple new pieces to the puzzle, looking up and down the roster, probably one of the most well-rounded groups that you've had since Coach Aw has taken over the Hoggard Viking program.
Yeah, it's been a while since we've had such a deep bench. We have, you know, 8 or 9 girls that can really step up and do good stuff for us. Trying to get everybody acclimated to how we do things has been a challenge at times, but I think we're starting to come together and do some good stuff.
This is a team 2-3 years removed from a 4A East Regional appearance, the first time, I believe, ever in Hoggard girls basketball program history. On that team, you had basically 3 players that were, you relied heavily on those 3 players. This season, as you kind of mentioned, you know, you're 8-9 players deep in a rotation. When you're talking girls varsity basketball, high school basketball across the scheme, boys or girls, when you're able to put in 7, 8, 9 different players throughout the course of a ball game, that must make you feel pretty confident that, you know, we have a bunch that could potentially make a run.
Yeah, it's good to know that we can rely on several different players. You know, not necessarily the same person steps up and is our leading scorer every game. We have different girls that we rely on for that, and it's good to see.
I would say that though we are in the midst of an enormous winning streak, you're 15-1, you've lost just 1 game so far this season. You rebounded from that only loss against Carolina Forest a couple of weeks ago. Best basketball still for Hoggard is in front of them, we hope, rather than what we've seen already at 15-1.
Right, yeah, we still feel like we really haven't put all the pieces together yet. You know, against Havelock, we had a pretty good performance all around, but really since then, we haven't quite put everything together. We're still waiting on that to happen.
You know, I know the girls, they're teenage girls, teenage boys on the boys' side. They look at the standings, they look at the stats, they look up and down the conference and say, you know, we have probably the best, most talented team out there. How hard is it to get the girls up for every game when they know, and maybe the coaches know, that, you know, we should come away with a win if we play our best basketball, but how hard is it to keep them motivated during this stretch when you're winning games pretty decisively?
No, we look at, try to just focus on that one game at a time. We know that every day is going to be a grind no matter who we play. We just have to come out and play the way we know how, and just take that one game at a time.
Well, we look up and down the roster, a couple of seniors that stand out for me. Tara Petit, she's been a point guard for you for a couple of years now. One of the best ball handlers in the area, really takes control of the basketball, takes care of the basketball when talking about turnovers. And Alani Fisher, a newcomer to the team last year, can shoot the rock from the outside. When she gets hot, she's hard to stop from anywhere on the floor. Elaborate on those 2 players and what they've meant to the program.
You know, Tara's been with us since she was a freshman. So this is her 4th year in the program. She knows the ins and outs better than anybody else out on the court, and it shows when she's out there. Takes control of the game. As far as Alani, you know, it's a huge boost for us bringing her in off the bench, bringing that gun, because like you said, when she gets hot, she's tough to stop.
Looking up through the roster now, Lola Lovett, Angel Smith, 2 kind of newcomers, transfers to the team this season. What type of talent do they provide and some depth that they provide to this team?
We've loved having them. Angel is very tough, very aggressive, powerful girl inside for us. And Lola is just an all-around player. She can score. You know, they've both been huge assets for us this season, for sure.
Joining those 2 newcomers in Lola Lovett, who's getting offers or at least looked at by some Division I basketball teams across the country, some returners to the team that are contributors as well. Blair Barefoot is one that stands out to me, just a sophomore, but she's another one of those players, kind of a spark plug that can come off the bench and do some big things for you.
Yeah, she does. She's great to have give Tara some spells, even having them in together at times. Where they can both handle the ball really well, and she's been a huge spark for us this year, no doubt.
person that could be, you know, key to your success this season, Keely Britt. She's a girl that is now taking over in the front court position along with Angel Smith down low. She had a career high, season high, 10 points the other night. How has her work and what type of work has she put in to get better to where she is now, you know, one of the key players to this team?
Yeah, Keely put in a lot of work in the offseason. I did a lot of individual work with her, and she worked on her own as well to improve her game. She's improving her strength, trying to get tougher inside for us because we need that inside presence because that's something we lack a lot of times.
Ellie Louthan, Olivia Hawkins, a couple of other bench players on this team that are going to be or have been getting some big minutes for you. How important is it for these types of players to be able to get minutes early in the season that come later on in the year when the pressure, you know, rises up to the playoff contention, battling for a conference championship, knowing that you have players that have varsity experience that have played minutes this year, significant minutes, to have those players on the bench that you have confidence to go to them when you need to?
Yeah, it's huge to be able to get them in early in the season like this and play minutes for us because we know come playoff time we're going to have to go 8-9 deep just to get that rotation through there for those bigger teams that we play.
As we wrap up the conversation this evening with assistant coach Eric Holley of the Hogger girls basketball program, coach, as we gear up for this midseason push now, you and New Hanover kind of sitting at the top, the X is on your back. How does this team kind of differ themselves from maybe teams in years past that have enjoyed success?
We know that every night we're going to get everybody's best. And trying to get the girls to buy into our system and what we do because we know it works. Just making that push through that is going to be key for us.
Coach Eric Holley, assistant coach of the Hoggard Lady Vikings, covering girls basketball tonight here on our show, Sports Roundtable. Thanks, Coach, for stopping by, and good luck here over the next couple of weeks.
Thanks, Joe. I appreciate it.
We'll catch up with Coach Holley in a couple, not next week, but the week following as we head through the month of January. Girls basketball, Mid-Eastern Conference schedule heating up. Heading into the second quarter of tonight's show as we talk with the four coaches from across New Hanover County, I'm Joe Katz. We'll take a quick timeout. High school basketball fans, welcome back to Sports Roundtable. I'm Joe Katz from PortCityDaily.com. We're catching up with the four girls basketball coaches from across New Hanover County this week. Thanks again to Coach Eric Holley, the assistant from Hoggard, for stopping by. The Vikings red hot right now as they head through the midseason push of the Mideastern Conference schedule. We have some veteran, I don't want to call them old, but some veteran coaches in New Hanover County on the girls basketball side of things. But our next guest is the newest member of this coaching alumni here in the county, and that's the head coach of the Laney Buccaneers and Ashley Berting. And Ashley, welcome to Sports Roundtable for the first time. I'm happy to have you here, and we look forward to catching up with Laney basketball throughout the course of the season.
Thanks for having me.
Coach, you are replacing I want to call her a legend because she's still around, but Sherry Tynes retired after this past season from coaching, and some big shoes to fill. She's been at Laney for a long time, and she really guided that Buccaneer program. How does that feel, one, to fill in some big shoes moving into this year?
Definitely huge shoes to fill. It's been a process coming in and me learning as well as teaching and, feeling that pressure a little bit, but it's the pressure I've always wanted, my dream to coach in Wilmington and varsity girls basketball.
Yeah, so. This is your first season at Laney, but not your first coaching stint. Last year, you were at South Brunswick High School. Your love for basketball obviously brought you here to Wilmington. Talk about maybe the history that you have playing the game, coaching in the game, and how you hope to learn to, find out what it takes to compete day in and day out here in New Hanover County.
I played 4 years in high school at Swansboro and played all 4 years on varsity. And then when I went to Western Carolina for grad school, I did a grad assistantship, and just that exposure of practices, film, scouting reports, everything like that really prepared me and opened me to a new level of basketball. And then, I coached JV girls for 2 years, and that was a great experience. I was able to run what I wanted to run, but still had that desire to coach varsity. And so took the job at South Brunswick, knew what I was going into, had a lot of growing pains, figured out some things I like, some things I didn't like, and I think it's all helped get me to where I am here at Laney, and definitely good experience along the way.
What are some of those things that you're learning as you become now a head coach at the varsity level? And each year, I think you probably take a little bit of something from the year prior. What are some of those things that you're learning as a coach, how to relate to players, what you expect from your players, and just yourself as a coach? What are you learning?
The one thing I think that has somewhat surprised me the most is that they're teenage girls. No matter what school you go to, you deal with the same sort of female personality of a 14, 15, 16-year-old girl. And so that's been pretty consistent. But, you know, when we went into overtime with West Brunswick the other week, that was my first overtime game. So figuring out timeouts and learning and asking, you know, is this when I take that opportunity to take the timeout? And so that, you know, going into the next game, hopefully we have no more overtime games, but if we do, I'm better prepared for that.
One of those coaches that are still around from Laney, we talk about those old coaches in New Hanover County on the girls' side, with the exception of yourself being Coach Vertha Dixon Wright at New Hanover, Coach All, now a veteran coach at Hoggard, and Coach Gale at Ashley and Monkey Junction, another one of those old coaches, an assistant on your bench still in Russ Adams, and the grandpa over there is grumpy at times, I could imagine, in practice and on the sidelines during games. But how does he help you throughout the course of a game in practice, and what he's been through, and how he's helping a young varsity basketball coach?
Yeah, he's been great. Obviously, I had the opportunity when I came in to hire whoever I wanted to. But for me, knowing that he had been there the past 20 plus years with Coach Tynes, I thought that was a huge asset for the transition of the program, for the girls, for myself, taking in every opportunity I can to continue to learn about the game. You know, in practices, he is great with scouting reports, and it's been different because everywhere I've been so far, I've ran everything from film to scouting to uniforms and everything. And so having some of that load taken off and, you know, just being shown the ropes of how things have been done, I've learned some things. I've also come in and changed some things, and he has taken to that, and I couldn't ask for a better assistant coming into this transition.
We're talking with the head coach, first-year head coach of the Laney girls basketball team, Ashley Birding. And Ashley, let's wrap up our conversation. Let's get to some of the players on the roster. Obviously, two players that stand out in the stat column each and every night. And obviously, from a leadership standpoint, Jensen Edwards and Lexi Melville, two key returners from last year. I know Jensen was hampered with a little shoulder injury earlier in the year. She's back in the lineup for you. How important are those two teams to the nucleus of Buccaneer basketball?
Very important. Obviously, Lexi has that experience. She played last year a lot as a sophomore in varsity. So that year older has really helped her confidence-wise as far as shooting and just expanding as a player. And Jensen, that really hurt, you know, her going out early in the season, but being able to recover and push through and work through the injury to get back out on the court after she did miss last year, you know, this was the first time I'd had the opportunity to see her play this year. And she's definitely on the court a leader that everybody is able to look to and steps our whole team level of play up.
Well, with her injury being out last year and being out for some of the beginning of this season, other players have obviously had to step up. Who on that roster has really stood out to you from an energy standpoint, and who you think could be pretty good in a Buccaneer uniform in the years to come?
Sydney Simpson is the hardest worker I have. You know, practice, games, rebounding. She's undersized, but she's playing a post for us right now. She will box out with the best of them, and basically her attitude is whatever it takes to get the ball for my team. And then Kiara Lloyd has stepped up. It's her senior year, but just the leadership vocally that we miss from other players, you know, staying in games and keeping her and everybody else hyped up and ready to go after defensive possessions. She's taken a couple big charges this year for us, and so she's been really key to what we're doing as well.
Coach Ashley Birding in her first season as the head coach of the Laney Buccaneers. Coach, did a great job, and we'll look forward to catching up in a couple weeks.
Thanks.
It's Coach Birding of the Laney Buccaneer basketball program. We are at the half here on Sports Roundtable. New Hanover, Ashley will check in with those two basketball programs as we head into the second half of tonight's show right after this quick break. Moving into the third quarter of tonight's show, we're catching up with the four high school basketball coaches, the girls coaches across New Hanover County tonight on Sports Roundtable. I'm Joe Katz from PortCityDaily.com. Thanks again to Coach Eric Holley, Coach Ashley Birding for stopping by in the first half of this evening's broadcast. Next up, we head down Market Street to Brogdon Hall as we talk with the head coach of the New Hanover Wildcats and Vertha Dixon, right? And Coach, a bittersweet moment moving through this season for yourself. I know your team knows, but maybe not many other people know. I know, but this is your last season running the Lady Wildcats basketball program. That's a tough moment, I guess, for you to say that this whole long journey of yours is now coming to an end.
Yeah, it has been a journey, but I think deep down inside, you know when it's time, and it's time. I've talked with my kids on, you know, several occasions. They understand. I think they understand. There'll be 8 seniors coming back. They know what they have to do, so they don't need me to stand on the sideline and tell them.
But they are playing inspired basketball, you can say, here to start the season on quite of a roll right now, and that's probably thanks to some of those returning players.
Yes.
A good senior class in the 3 seniors you have, and your captain, Ayanna Cotton, Kaylee Merrill down low for you.
That's right.
Those are two players who have been key contributors to this program for quite some time.
Right.
What are you going to miss most about them, not only when you leave the sidelines, but when they graduate this year?
I'm probably going to miss them just being around. You know, they're constantly popping their heads into the office, walking up on me in the cafeteria. Coach, you watched that game on TV last night? Just watching them, you know, in general, it's going to be good. But they're going to be in a good place. I know they are. We're going to make sure they pick the right school. They all have offers, and it's going to be hopefully somewhere close where I can stay on the road and go watch and play. So I'll still keep my eyes on them a little bit.
Junior class, pretty talented group of players you have. Azaria Fields at the point guard position, Amani Muhammad, a player that can score the rock from anywhere really on the court.
Right.
You know, what stands out to you about them and the way they've developed as players here over the last couple of seasons?
It's been great, you know, to see the transformation. When they first came in, a little raw. I can't take all the credit. They were all on excellent AAU teams, and you know I'm not an AAU fan, but I've seen them improve through the summer. And to be watching from a distance to see them their final year is still going to be good because I know they're going to excel at what they do.
We've got some highlights from the Wildcats' start to the season, so let's check these out as we move into a big week for yourself in conference play and as you look to stay atop the league and really trying to push yourself over the top this season to finish as conference champions.
It'd be great, yep. This is against Ashley at our home court. Always good competition when we play those guys.
I would say we have to thank the New Hanover County Schools TV production team for this broadcast, right?
We were kind of glad to see them there because I know I can get a good tape out of that one, you know. Little teenage managers sometimes don't do as well as they do.
Brogdon Hall, obviously, I don't want to say a new look, but it must feel a bit cooler in there with the air conditioning now installed inside that historic gym.
It has made a difference. It really has. Temperature-wise, if it's cold outside, we get the heat instantly. And, of course, it's been a lot, you know, a little warm days, so we get the AC kicks on. So it pretty much keeps the temperature workable. So that's good for us.
What I'm noticing here in some of these highlights is you like to dial up the pressure full court style, force the other team into mistakes, and actually had a tough time just getting the ball across half court in this ball game.
Yeah, sometimes our press is exceptional. Everybody's right where they're supposed to be. They're shifting where they're supposed to be, and it makes us look good. But then sometimes when we're out of position, it makes us look bad. That's a great shot by Amaya Marshall, who is a senior also, who last year didn't play with us, but you know, wanted to come back and finish her year. She had some things going on, and she has actually given us a lot of good minutes. Kind of glad to see her back out there.
Good ball movement around the perimeter, and then some interior passing there for the easy 2 points.
That's Michelle Jacobs bringing the ball up. She's been a pleasant surprise. We would like to see her shoot the ball a little more than what she's doing, but she's just willing to give it up. That's Kadeem Allen's little sister.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah, so she rather pass than shoot. So
Kadeem Allen, if fans don't know, is currently a senior at the University of Arizona.
Doing well.
Yeah, big-time player in the Pac-12 right now. And yeah. Michelle Jacobs, maybe his talent rubbing off on her
Hope
a little bit.
So.
But when you have a young player like that, a player that isn't accustomed to shooting the ball, even though she has some talent,
yes.
Is it more of a confidence thing, knowing that, you know, let me take a couple shots and when they go in, then I gain that confidence?
That's exactly right. And, you know, we constantly are telling Michelle, shoot, in practice, most of the time she's nonstop, you know, and getting the ball game is, here, let me give it to Ayana, or let me give it to Imani, let me give it to anybody. And then her last thought is, maybe I should shoot the ball. And her percentages are pretty good, so we'd like to see her shoot the ball a little more.
No yeah. question, moving into the year, the preseason favorites to win the conference, Hoggard and yourself atop yeah. the division. That's where things stand right now. I have a feeling that's the way things are going to go all the way to the end of the season until you two meet up again, potentially for a conference tournament championship or the second time around having to play each other in another highly contested ball game. You have some depth this year to match maybe what Hoggard brings to the floor. What's it going to take for you guys to finally get over the hump and beat those Vikings?
To get over the hump, number one, reduce the number of turnovers. We sometimes get in a hurry, and by being in a hurry, we don't make good decisions, and therefore we turn the ball over a lot. We've got to be very patient. We got to rely on each other. We got to rely on each other even when things aren't going well to know, hey, this is a 32-minute game. Let's just play it second by second and play hard, and something good is going to come out of it.
Coach Vertha yeah. Dixon Wright, I didn't mean to call you old in the last segment. I meant experienced and a wise
Same thing.
Coaching legend here
Same
at New
thing.
Hanover High School.
Okay.
Wrapping up our final season, it's always fun catching up with you, Coach, and we'll
Thank
talk
you.
To you next couple weeks.
Yes.
Head coach of the New Hanover Wildcats, Vertha Dixon Wright, stopping by in the third quarter of tonight's show. Wildcats red hot right now. I believe they're winners of 8 straight, right atop the division, searching for a conference championship this season. And Coach Dixon Wright's final season on the sidelines at Brogdon Hall. Take our final timeout tonight. Head to the fourth quarter of tonight's show with the head coach of the Ashley Screaming Eagles, Adrian Gale, coming up next. High school basketball fans, welcome back to Sports Roundtable, heading into the fourth quarter of tonight's show as we continue our first edition talking with the girls basketball coaches from across New Hanover County. I'm Joe Katz from PortCityDaily.com out in Monkey Junction. Adrian Gale beginning another season as the head coach of the Ashley Screaming Eagles. She joins me here on stage tonight. And Coach, been a tough go at it so far this season. Why don't you just talk a little bit about some of the players on the team, how the roster is shaped up moving through this midseason push now, and some general thoughts on the early season schedule.
Yeah, you know, losing 4 out of 5 starters from last year hurts. And you can see that we are trying to figure out our lineup, kind of, who's ready to play, people that are willing to step up and kind of produce a little bit more. A lot of girls are going into trying to identify new roles, which is a lot to ask in a short period of time. You know, the summer really is not enough time to kind of throw people into these new roles and get used to all the playing and I guess pressure, if you want to say, that they need to have to be successful and to try to get the team running and going.
One of the players out of the 4 of 5 starters that you lost, one returning, Dana Craig, has mm-hmm. been a staple for you over the last couple of seasons. I know you've been high on what she's been doing throughout the course of her high school basketball career, and I'm sure just building off of that this season and really one of the key leaders on your team.
Yeah, definitely. You know, she's been one of the girls that's been with me for 4 years, so you know, we're trying to, you know, get her to be a good leader and step up and, you know, not give her too much pressure, but understand that the offense is going to revolve through her, whether she, you know, scores or touches the ball, you know, passes it back out to some of the guards or, you know, hopefully takes advantage of the height advantage that she has with a lot of teams and goes to the basket nice and strong.
Talk about some of the newcomers to the team or some returners that you're asking to step into a bigger role moving through the year.
Yeah, you know, Vanessa Fay is one of our, you know, players from last year. So, you know, we expect a lot from our post play. We think that we have a decent size compared to some of the other teams in the conference. So we were hoping that, you know, our post play is strong and powerful And, you know, we need that to be successful on offensive end. And then, you know, with our guard play, you know, we're still kind of adjusting and making some changes. Morgan and Kendall been our top, you know, defending guards, and now we're asking them to do a lot more on the offensive end. So that's a lot of responsibility for them, but they're you know, fighting and doing what they need to do to try to get the team running.
Vanessa, a player who a couple of years ago saw minimal time on the floor, how much has she improved as a player to give you the confidence, you know, to put her out there?
You know, she's one of those players that she doesn't know how good she can be, and you know, if she used her strength to go to the basket strong and you know, her aggressiveness to get there, she could do a lot of damage.
Well, I know we got some highlights from a game against New Hanover from earlier this year, so let's take a look at some of the you know, matchup over at Brogdon Hall from a couple weeks back.
Yeah, that's Taylor Long. She played JV the last 2 years for us, and she is, you know, a good shooter, and we are looking to get her the ball and get involved in the offense a little bit more in the last couple of weeks. So we're just trying to, again, get a feel of our identity, you know. A lot of the girls, you know, they don't know really what to do or how to do it right. And, you know, they want to do so much. They do care and they want to play hard, you know. But, you know, we try to take one step at a time and just, you know, don't do too much. Just do what, you know, you can do to help the team out on both ends of the floor and be aggressive. You know, sometimes you see that we're a little passive with pressure, and I think, you know, that is something that we've been trying to work on and break, and just be strong with the ball and not give in to pressure.
Well, there's one of the few times that you're able to avoid that pressure, and I know New Hanover, a team that likes to press up on the floor, and many of the conference foes that you're going to face this year, especially here in the county, they like to play that high-pressure defense, so it's not an easy task for some of these girls to be learning kind of on the fly.
Yeah, you know, we're just trying to stay positive with them and, you know, trying to explain, like, okay, if there's team with pressure, a lot of times you can get a layup off of it, you know? So if you're willing to attack the pressure and beat it, then you can get an easy basket off of it. But if we kind of cower down and back away from it, then it's going to, you know, work in favor for the defensive team.
What are some of the most important things that you tell your team when you have a team that, you know, is going to full court press you like a New Hanover?
You know, just don't back down. You know, try not to back down. Try to be aggressive. You know, try to swing the ball, move the ball fast, and push the ball up the court. But, you know, do it in a good way, in a smart way. You know, we had a lot of turnovers that game. And, you know, again, you could just see that people are uncomfortable with the ball and they just want to get rid of it instead of having the confidence and belief in themselves that they can do the job.
Who do you see maybe here the next couple of games, or have you seen through practice that you really think could, you know, you can rely on a little bit more heavily than you would expect it maybe earlier on in the season?
You know, I think that some of the younger ones are starting to mature a little bit and come around a little bit. Jackie Ingram, she's been coming in at the post play and just very aggressive player, and that's what we're kind of looking for. Like, I'd rather you make aggressive mistakes than passive mistakes, and just kind of go out there, grind and push and you know, don't back down from people. So she's been getting a lot of playing time in the last couple days and games, and also in practice, just been able to push Dana and push some of our bigs around to get them ready to play.
Well, thank you a lot on the key word here. Let's keep grinding over at Monkey Junction, and we'll catch up with you in a couple weeks.
All right, sounds good.
This is Ashley, Screaming Eagles head girls basketball coach Adrienne Gale here on Sports Roundtable as we wrap up tonight's show. We appreciate the folks here at New Hanover County Schools TV for producing tonight's broadcast. We'll be back next week with the four boys basketball coaches from the four Wilmington high schools here on Sports Roundtable. Until next time.